गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो टुडेज़ क्लास इज़ अबाउट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट वी शुड नो व्हाट इज़ डिजास्टर, व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ डिजास्टर एंड वील सी व्हाट इज़ द मैनेजमेंट एंड विद फ्यू एग्जांपल्स। सो फर्स्ट वील सी व्हाट इज़ द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिजास्टर। सो व्हाट इज़ द डिजास्टर? So disaster, according to UNISDR, it is United Nations Office for Disasters Reduction, 2009. They define disaster as a serious disruption of the functioning of a community or a society involving widespread human, material, economic or environmental losses and impacts which exceed the ability of the affected community or society to cope using its own resource. So basically, in a simpler form, disaster impacts may include the loss of life, injuries, disease and other negative effects on human physical, mental and social well-being. So together with there will be damage to the property, destruction of asset, loss of service, social and economic disruption, and there will be environmental destruction or degradation. So according to the Disaster Management Act 2005 of India, it uses disaster, states the disaster as a catastrophe, calamity or grave occurrence in any area arising from, it can be either from natural natural source or man-made, okay. Or it can be accidental or negligence, which results in substantial loss of life, or there will be damage to the environment. So that is what the disaster means. So as I told you, there are two types of disaster that I will be telling later. Next slide. Moving on. So there are two types of disaster: natural disaster and human-induced disaster. When we the natural disaster example, like we in our country, there are different the country had faced different types of disaster in case of natural as well as human induced, like floods. Recently in 2018 there was a flood in Kerala, in Kerala state of our country, and earthquakes like Gujarat, in Gujarat, which had happened. And other Bhopal gas tragedy, that is human induced. These are few examples of human induced disaster. This will be seen later in few slides, like during the examples we'll be discussing it. So as I told you, there are different types of natural disaster: earthquakes, cyclones, floods, tidal waves, landslides, volcanic eruptions and all. So so depending upon the density and distribution of the population, the effects will be more. Like for example, in case of earthquake, there will be many deaths will be there and injuries also, while compared to other disaster. So earthquakes and floods are the major serious disaster, and there will be increased number of deaths. So every catastrophic event has its own special features. Like for example, each one has special features. Like cyclones and floods can be, we can predict several hours or days before in case of cyclones and floods, whereas earthquakes occur without any warning. So these are the different types within the natural disaster. There are different few features. And the number of injuries, deaths differs, depends upon the disaster. Human disaster, it can be due to chemicals, nuclear, biological and radiological. This is human induced disaster is mainly due to rise in population and rapid urbanization and industrialization. In this case, there will be certain zones or high risk areas are affected more. Okay, and there will be environmental degradation and climate change aggravate the vulnerabilities to various kinds of disasters. So when there is a climate change and environmental change, there will be these areas are more vulnerable. It will become more vulnerable to these types of disaster. So disaster preparedness, that will be telling how to manage if there are different stages in disaster how to manage disaster. There are a few aspects of disaster management will be telling that. During that, how do you go about human in case of human disaster management and natural disaster? We'll be seeing that on following slides. We'll move on. Fundamental aspects of disaster management. For this, we need to know how do you manage a disaster. Okay. There are various types of disaster, and these various disasters are managed in different ways. Okay. So there should be for the management of disaster, there should be a systematic process of using administrative decisions. Like from the government, there should be a decision like these areas are vulnerable and these areas are more prone. They should categorize these area. Okay, and the organization should come front, and they have to help the areas which is being affected, and they should have a policies and strategies how to cope up, like how to bring a normal life to that community or an area. Okay, so there are as we are seeing in this slide, there are three different fundamental aspects of disaster management. In which a few are like how to before the disaster and after the disaster, like disaster preparedness and mitigation are before disaster happen, we should be prepared and we should prevent the disaster. And response, it is like following the disaster, what are the things we should be doing. So before and after, okay. These are the different phases. So coming to we'll be telling on each slide. So first we'll discuss our disaster response. Okay, in this slide we are we'll be seeing with examples, like same thing it is with examples. So disaster preparedness means activities prior to a disaster. As I told you, mitigation and preparedness, it is prior to the disaster. So before the before the disaster occur, we should be prepared. Like we should there should be a proper strategic plan for a certain areas which are vulnerable. We should identify those areas and we should make the people, for example, like people living in a near to the dam. So there should be a fog alarm, or the people who had experienced any type of earthquakes. So that those areas should be they should have a preparedness plan. So how to go about, like emergency training and all, they should pack everything. Areas which are vulnerable to floods, so those areas there should be when there is increased heavy rains, people should be aware of the risk of flooding. So they should pack everything. Emergency kit should be ready. So and warning systems. Okay, they should be the authorities should warn the people in that area. So all those things beforehand. Okay, before the disaster. Okay, and mitigation, it is the activity that reduces the effect of disaster. So it is like building codes, preventing urbanization and industrialization. This can prevent so many man-made disaster and other natural disaster also. In preparedness also, like there will be, if there is a cyclones coming up or any floods because of heavy rain, so it can be predicted, right? So accordingly we have to plan and we have to move from that area. People have to be shifted from that area to another. Okay, And coming to disaster response and recovery, following the disaster, the people should be public warning system should be in place, and emergency operations, search and rescue, and first aid, field care, triage system should be opened. So these are the things we'll be seeing in response and recovery following the activities. Temporary housing should be given to the people who experience this type of disaster and who are being affected. So claims processing and grants, insurance, all those things, medical care and counseling, all those things should be given in the recovery phase. So this is how you manage a disaster. So first step in disaster management is following the disaster, what are the things to be done. So that is disaster response following an impact. Okay, so first is the search, rescue and first aid. So in search, rescue and first aid, after a major disaster, the uninjured people should be identifying those who are not injured and rescue them and providing them the first aid. So that is the most important or first response which comes from the uninjured person. So following that, field care means most injured person's coverage spontaneously to health facility. So there will be rush, they should be rushed to the health facility, and there should be transport should be available, and what are the and provide proper care to the individuals. If there is any surgical service needed, they should be the surgical service should be given properly, and food and shelter should be provided. A center should be established to respond, to inquire from the patients, relatives and friends, so that there will be, and priority should be given to the victim's identification, adequate mortuary space, and all those things should be provided. Following field care, that means there should be health, a temporary health setup should be provided in near to that area where the impact has occurred. So next is the so first I told search, rescue, first aid, and then field care, then triage. So in triage, here first come first treated, it is not at all followed. Okay, in an emergency, there will be different coding like red, yellow, green and all, so we need not go to that, but severity depending upon the severity of the illness, these are classified. Okay, red indicates high priority, and yellow indicates medium priority, and green indicates ambulatory patients. Okay, and black for dead. So these are the different color coding given in emergencies. So depending upon the severity of the illness, patients have to be treated, and they should be given immediate care. Okay, and next is the tagging. Identification of the dead or the all patients should be even not even the dead, all patients should be identified with tags stating their name, age, place of origin, triage category, diagnosis and initial treatment. So these things should be there in that tag. And next comes the identification of the dead. So taking care of dead is essential part in a disaster management. A large number of dead can also impede or destruct the efficiency of the rescue. Okay, so removal of the dead from the disaster scene, it is so these are the care. Okay, removal of the dead from the disaster scene, shifting of the shifting to the mortuary, identification and giving handing over to the after identification, we can hand over to the patient or the dead relatives. Okay, so coming to the relief phase, in case immediately following a disaster, the more critical health, like everybody will be discussion towards the healthcare setup. So, no matter what type of disaster, there will be affected persons and dead people will be taken to the, they will be taken to the mortuary, and the people who are injured, okay, they will be taken to the hospitals and casualties. So, following a disaster, it is like a relief phase means there should be food should be provided to the people, clothing should be provided, shelter should be provided, and sanitary and other equipments and materials should be provided to the individuals. So these things are happen in a relief phase. So supplies are those needed for treating casualties and preventing the spread of communicable disease. So following the disaster, there will be overcrowding and population displacement and all. So this may lead to domestic and this may lead to communicable disease. So there will be people will become in contact with the animals. So there will be zoonotic diseases will be emerging, and there will be lack of food and contaminated water. So these are things we'll be seeing in rehabilitation. Okay, so for relief phase and rehabilitation, it is a part like as we have discussed in disaster cycle. Following a disaster, response, relief phase, rehabilitation. Okay, in the relief phase, what are the things will be given to the people, like healthcare setup, and what are the other things like shelter, food, everything. And following that, during that also we have to see is following the overcrowding and poor sanitation, what are the things people if there is any outbreak of zoonotic disease or leptospirosis, for example, leptospirosis and rickettsiosis and all. So if there is any need of vaccination, we should provide. Actually, WHO does not recommend typhoid and cholera vaccine in routine, but in protocol they are saying like there should be vaccination for typhoid, cholera and tetanus depending upon their endemic areas. Tetanus no matter where they can be provided. Okay, coming to the nutritional aspect, there will be loss of food. The nutrition status of different population will be different. So depending upon that, food and nutritional condition will be the vulnerable group should be identified, and those groups should be given. They should be given food. For example, like infants, children, nursing mothers, they should be identified and they should be given proper care and food. Okay, coming to the rehabilitation phase, in a disaster, there should be restoration of pre-disaster condition, the water supply, food safety. If there is any contamination of the water, we should be checked, and the source of water should be checked. If there is any chemical, in case of chemical disaster and all, the water should be checked for any contamination, and there will be mixing of the excreta, sanitary wells and all. So those things should be taken care. And food safety, proper food has to be provided, and vector control if there is any outbreak dengue, chikungunya and all, those things should be taken care of, and basic sanitation and personal hygiene. So these are the important. So coming to disaster mitigation, as I told you before, it is before disaster occurring, so it is like a prevention. So emergency prevention and mitigation involves measures designed either to prevent hazards from causing emergency or to lessen the likely effects of emergency. So this disaster mitigation and preparedness, they go hand in hand. Okay, so here we have to identify the areas which is vulnerable, like for example, in a area where there is flood can happen, the people who are living near to the dams. So they should be educated, they should be given proper guidelines or strategic plans. So how, when warning signals, okay, they how they go about, and the government should take necessary action to shift the community from that place to another. So and while doing disaster mitigation, we can reduce the medical casualties, and we can improve the quality of house, like we, the building area, building codes can be given. So in certain area, which is the area which is vulnerable to earthquakes, and also how the building should be, how it should be constructed, and all, we can give a proper guidelines. And same thing in disaster preparedness also. It is a long-term development activity. So this, as I told you before, it goes hand in hand. So the objective of disaster preparedness is to ensure that appropriate system, procedures, and resources are in place to provide prompt, effective assistance to disaster victims, thus facilitating their measures and rehabilitation service. Okay, so whatever whatever sources are available to the victims, there should be rehabilitation service, there should be relief service, the food, water, proper shelter. So these before only we have to arrange, like how we have to prepare people before the disaster occurs. Okay, for so in case of flood, so this is a flood which happened in Kerala in 2018. So in case of flood, during the time of flood, what are things we should do before the flood, what are things, I'll be discussing few points with you. So while planning the town, it is government responsibility that they should tell the individuals about the risk in the area where they live. Okay, and for example, like people who live in areas downstream from a dam, they should know special signals such as fog horns. Okay, these fog horns are used when a dam threatens to break. Okay, so for example, so this is a like before hand. Okay, it is like prevention. So these are the mitigation steps that will be given to the people. And during a flood, what are the things we should be doing, like turning off the electricity to reduce the risk of electrocution, protect the people and property, and contamination of the water, and evacuate the danger zone as ordered by the local authorities and all. So they should be, here in this picture we can see that people are taken away from that place in a lorry and shifted them to a safer zone. This is an picture showing the earthquake happened in Nepal during the year 2015. So in earthquake beforehand, what are things which we should be doing? So in earthquake, the movement of ground in an earthquake is rarely the direct cause of injury. Most are caused by falling objects. So it is not the movement of the ground, it is because of the falling of the objects or collapsing of the building. So mainly death or injuries occurring because of that. So build in accordance with urban planning regulations. So what are the urban planning regulations should be you should be knowing, and ensure that all electricals and gas appliances in the house together with the all pipes connected to them. Okay, avoid storing heavy objects, materials, and hold family evacuation drills, and ensure that all family knows what to do in case of earthquake. Prepare a family emergency kit. So these are the important points beforehand, what all things should be doing. And during an earthquake, do not be panic, keep calm, and people who are indoors should stay there but move to the central part of the building and keep away from the stairs, which might collapse suddenly. Okay, so after an earthquake, obey the authority. Do not go back to the damaged building since tremors can be happen. So these are the few pictures like in earthquakes of earthquakes of magnitude 7.8 struck Nepal on May 1, 2015, killing more than 10,000 people. Same pictures of Nepal earthquake. People are rescuing. This is in human induced disaster. It is in Madhya Pradesh. So in the year 1984, this was one of the largest human made disaster. Released methyl isocyanate into the air. So this gas has provided, this has, gas has taken many people's lives. You should know about the Disaster Management Authority, which is started during the year 2005 by Disaster Management Act. So in this Disaster Management Authority, according to the federal structure of India, the state government is responsible for the execution of relief work. And for other type of disaster, whatever it is happening in a particular area, the state governments are responsible. And other and the National Disaster Management Authority will be guiding, they will be only guiding the state government, and they will be providing the funds also. So other than national and state level, various NGOs also work for disaster management. And Indian Meteorological Department play a key role in forewarning the disaster. So it has 5 centers for tracing cyclones in India. One is in Kolkata, Bhubaneswar, Visakhapatnam, Chennai, Mumbai. These 5 states are for detection of the detection as well as tracing of cyclone storms, and thereby we can predict it. Thank you.